Just kind of bring it in if y'all don't mind. Kind of calm down. Everybody's all riled up about Easter. We got a nice beautiful day out here to go look at some leaf litter bags. So today we're going to break up into groups of five, since there's five of us. I think there'll be four groups of three and one group of four. So what we're going to do is we're done here and I'll put some leaf litter bags out on Friday afternoon about 2, 3 o'clock. We had a little rain since then, but hopefully we'll still have some cool critters in there. So what we're going to do is we'll look at some different species today, kind of hopefully some crane flies, stone flies. We actually got a little friend with us today, Brandon's going to break out. Where's the spray bottle?
Oh, hang on a second. Could I send a volunteer back to the van to get the spray bottle? I forgot all about. Thank you, Zach. Appreciate it. That's okay.
Anyway, let's keep on rolling. So while Mr. Weaver goes and gets the spray water for us, we're going to get him out. Man, his name's Sanford. It's a tiger salamander. Does anybody know why they're probably called a tiger salamander?
Stripes.
The way he looks.
Stripes?
The way he looks.
Way he eats. How's he eat?
Hey, can you come up here?
Ashley, can you come do that for the whole group? Okay. So when lions and cats eat, they shake their head to usually break the neck or spinal cord, however gruesome it would be about it. Same thing with him. He'll shake his worm or whatever. That's what they say his favorite food is, the worm.
Yeah.
So today we hope we can find something not like him, because tiger salamanders aren't in North America. But there are some marble salamanders, I believe is what they're called, and they're in here. They're in North America. But we probably won't find anything that size. The marble salamander is that size at full grown. He's only about 3/4 of the way grown. So we won't find anything that big probably, but if you do, that'd be pretty cool. So anyway, I think Mr. Weaver right now is coming from the water. So Brandon will get him out and handle him, and if y'all want to pet him, y'all can. But y'all should disinfect y'all's hands. And their skin is really wet, and ours is really dry, apparently. So if you pet him with your dry hands, it's going to stick to him. And if it sticks, that's probably not the best thing in the world. So
while he's doing that, I just want to take a quick precaution. Be careful when you're going down through here. When Chris is setting up the bags, he did see a snake.
It was a harmless, non-venomous snake, little friend.
Yeah, just be aware of your surroundings. Yep.
It's not down in there. It's a different location, but we should be good. Anyway, sure. Sanford has got the cutest little smile you ever seen. It smiles about which as Brandon's pool does. So does anybody want to maybe pet Sanford? Anybody at all?
Show a hand.
Don't be scared to pet him. He won't bite.
Before you handle them,
there you go.
Let's get y'all some hand sanitizer real quick.
Make sure if you're handling them, just keep them close to the ground just in case he falls.
There you go. Great.
There you go. Try your best when you're holding him to keep him close to the ground, so that way if he falls, then he's not going to have a long way to go.
Just some water. Some distilled water here.
Good.
And before we do these leaf litter bags, we'll go down here and actually do an example one together real quick. And we only have two sifting buckets. So what we're going to do is we're going to work our way upstream so nobody downstream has cloudy water, dirty water. So when the first deserves, you'll sift out your leaves and what's in your leaf litter bag and get out, put it in your little tub right here. And you'll hand it to the next group in front of you. I have to skip one. But it shouldn't take very long. Yeah, every group, you'll just do one leaf litter bag at each location. We have a location out here. It's a little more woody, and we have another location up there. It's a little more rocky. We actually haven't done that location yet, so it's a little new, so that'd be cool.
Good, Brandon. Good deal.
We'll do that. Is there any questions before we go down here and we start doing an example, give out the worksheets to put everybody in the group? Is everybody excited?
Yeah.
Woo!
Okay.
Well,
I see a snake, I will be.
Yeah. We'll do it after we do the example.
Okay.
Alrighty, so about the groups, what we'll do is we'll put you in groups after we do our example one, but don't start clicking up because we're actually going to sign you into your own groups. So anyway,
just sit up there and
show
you. Just get it outside. Thank you very much.
You want to grab
him?
That'd be awesome.
Yeah, Mr. Crump, we're just going to put him over there. Thank you very much. Just in the shade.
Alright, guys, let's watch your steps as we go down here. Keep pulling. Or
right there. We gotta make sure we don't forget it. We're good. No, that's perfect. I just didn't want him out in the sun. That's why I love that red bag. It stands out, you know? Thank you very much. He should be just fine back in the shade.
Yeah,
All right.
Again, just be mindful of where they're stepping. Try to pay attention to, no talking.
Is that good on that side?
No, I can't get it on the
Let's give Matt a few more moments to get over here and kind of tie it around here. Hopefully, see. What you got down there?
He's off rail.
Alrighty. I'm going to step right here. I've got all these flare bags out for me. Right here. Does everybody see these zip ties? This one, the rain kind of washed some stuff on top of it, but hopefully, we'll have something in it. Everybody kind of see? But you know, this pink flag and see some zip ties? What you do is you need a partner to do this with, so just pull some people up here and kind of stand right here. What you do is there should be some rocks laying down so it doesn't wash it away. You're going to take all the rocks off. You're going to do this pretty quickly. Just going to scoop it up right here, toss it in there. It's a rock. So this part you're going to do is you're going to kind of stand out here. You'll be downstream from where you're gathering water, because right now it's making all this cloudy and dirty. It kind of defeats the purpose of cleaning it all out. So just put one, so you can kind of dump those leaves in here. Open the back of that leaf in there, that doesn't fit there, excuse me. Yeah, so we're going to open it. We have this little paper clip right here. I'm sure everybody uses one of these alligator clips. You just kind of pull it off, set it off the side. Make sure you don't lose it. Remember, we're using it for a part of the labs, and we don't want to leave the cabinet completely in the woods here. Just dump it all in there and sift it out at once. All right, I already see a couple of critters in there running around. Something out of here. If you want to just dump all that in here, Brandon, you can. In case there's some smaller stuff in there. Mm-hmm. Now you might get a little dirty, but all this should wash out. I don't see any. Anything that'll stain your clothes. I mean, it's kind of particular about their clothes. So just make sure you keep both your mesh bags out. Kind of set them off to the side if y'all don't mind. And we're going to use that same tub right there. And we're going to run some water through this. See all that kind of that sand and silt in there? We're going to use some water to kind of wash that down the screen. Now, you shouldn't lose any macroorganisms through this drain. This screen here is pretty big. So we just pull this, give us some water here. Gotta get it. Kind of pour it in there, sift it through. Do that one or two times. Like I said, after you get it sifted through and everything, just kind of hand your bucket to the next, not the next group, because we're doing two buckets, but hand the one above them. Just kind of try to run it up, somebody run it up there to them real quick. When you're doing those leaf lure bags, a person farthest down the street, you're going to start first, so everybody has some clear water to work with. Alrighty.
We'll let you know when the next group goes.
Yep. So we're going to step off the dry land here since it's standing in the water. And we have an ice cube tray, or a zoo. Because they zoo, that's a little more cool than ice cube. So you're going to get some real clear water in here. Just kind of get in there. You don't want it all the way full. Just half these little cubes full is fine. Good, and you're going to start just going through this a leaf at a time. And we have some forceps. Nobody likes these, kind of like a grub right here. Two grubs, actually. We call them grubs, it's a slang term. We'll find out what they are, really are here in a few moments. It's kind of, so this zoo, you want to use each thing's kind of compartment for its own little species. Like I said, we have some little handouts. Can you hand out those laminated sheets for me? Or just hold one up, actually, we'll hand them out when we get in groups. So there's nice little laminated sheets here. So if you get some water on them, it's not the end of the world. So you're going to use these laminated sheets to identify some of the species you find. Did you find something down there, Mr. Weaver?
Yeah, I got these for a moment.
It's not quite dying. Oh, yeah.
We can go down here and look at it. It might be a good teachable moment. What'd you find down here, Mr. Weaver?
Just a
find a little frog down here. I'm not up to date on my amphibian identification. What that may be, Dr. Furman?
I think it's it's not a leopard frog. It may just be just an old green frog. He's on his way out there, it looks like. Let's
and we'll leave him be. Maybe he'll
kind of, yeah.
Maybe he's taking a little fat nap. Anyway, back up here, what we're doing. A little green frog passing away.
Interesting, yep.
Giving carbon back to the earth. Because instead of forcing to kind of do this, Mr. Cool started separating some stuff out here. They're just going to look at these little insects, kind of look at their body structure and what kind of, how many legs they have, body compartment, stuff like that, and kind of use this identification guide. So, Anne, would you want to come try to identify all these bugs for us real quick? You don't have to touch it. You just kind of look at it. Just don't touch it. Or you can identify this grub or whatever. Yeah, that's why I sat down. Like I said, she's doing that. You just want to take these out and kind of just kind of want to do one. I believe that's what it is. And what's that called on the sheet?
Lepidoptera.
Lepidoptera. So, does anybody have any questions about this at all? So you can do this kind of one leaf at a time, just kind of go through it. Now we're going to break up into groups. Before you have the...
All right. So here's what we're going to do right now. I have in my pocket right here, numbers 1 through 5. If you get a 1, then you will be going with Chris. If you get a 2, you'll be going with John. If you get a 3, you'll be going with Jesse. If you get a 4, you'll be going with CJ. If you get a 5, you're going to bring up the caboose with me. All right? So, everyone take one piece of paper.
How many, each group has how many leaflet bags?
One on this side.
In this stream, everybody have one leaf litter bag, and then we'll go to another stream. It's a little bit different type of habitat, and you'll have one leaf litter bag there.
All right.
Oh, we got a little clam here.
Oh, yeah.
Give me the
4. So since we're done with this one, that's all your little specimens once you kind of use them. And if it's something that's not on your sheet, we all should have the that Project Noah on your phone. And if you don't, you just kind of take a picture. You can upload the picture of your species to the site. So I'm going to pull these back in the water here.
Awesome.
I'm a number 2.
Beautiful. Yeah.
So as we go to the stream, 1 will be all the way in back, so 5. 5 is this flag right here, so we're kind of...
It's Dakota. Is there 3 people per group?
Yeah. Every group has 1 sheet, so you just have to fill out one of these, put all your names on it. Yes, ma'am?
Is there 3 people per group?
Yes, and I think one group might have 4. Oh, if we could get 1 representative from each group to come up and grab your equipment, and then we'll get ready to head on out.
Two.
I need our equipment. Or you guys? Brandon, you want 5
to be right here, 1 should be right here.
We'll just do 5. I'll just kind of do it. Just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay, so I go all the way to the back.
Yeah, all the way to the back. It's just right around that curve.
Okay.
So it'll be 1, 2. So there should be 3 flags. You'll see right there.
Say 1 number.
Alright, so 1's you're going to be with me, but we're going to stay right here kind of, so everybody's going to kind of go out in order of numbers. So who's group number 5? Who's the leader?
Group number 3.
I think so.
Who's a member of group number 1?
You are?
You want to grab this stuff?
Hey, Chris.
Yeah. We're going to do it in order of groups. So what number are you? 2, so you'll be the next flag officer.
Yeah.
Does anybody have one of these zoos?
No.
Yep. Has everybody got...
Everybody got a zoo, four sets, and one bucket.
You don't have 4 sets?
Yeah, we got 4 sets. And remember, guys, try to stay out of the stream so you don't cause a bunch of disturbance down here. Just kind of keep the water clear. And we'll let you know when the next group can go. We'll say one's done, two's done, three's done, four's done. So when you hear the group in front of you is done, you can continue to take your leaf litter bag out.
All right, so we're going to need to pause for 1 second while...
Yep. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and take our bag out right here. And I'll get on this.
As soon as you take the bag out, we can go there, right?
Yep.
Mr. Crump, there's a little teachable moment right here, this little fella.
Oh, we got a little frog. Something right here, too, a little teachable moment. Our group just kind of come right here. Looks like a leopard frog?
It might be a little baby leopard frog. Look at him. Whoop, whoop, whoop.
There you go. See him right there? Maybe a little baby leopard frog.
All right.
This stream's pretty active right now, so we have 2 people down here. Somebody take the rocks off. Somebody have a little tub.
Got some rocks.
Group two, y'all can take your little leaf litter bag out.
All right, let's do it.
Small gravel.
I guess I can pull it out for you. Lost the encoder. You see it?
Raccoon.
Hold on. There we go. I'm a trained professional.
Go back around where we don't want to go.
Group three, y'all should be good.
Okay. Back around.
I'll grab some for you. We good? So we got a zoo ready to go.
Get ourselves away.
I'm going to
just get my creek out of the way. Get it in there fast. Alright, let's go to this right over here. The flat tattoo right here.
Where y'all can get to it.
While we wait, by all the stuff going on, this is a good
looking for
right.
We took that. Want me to help you down?
No.
I can help you.
We're not supposed to be playing in the street.
Well, all the other groups already went and got theirs. So.
I'm good.
Okay. Are you gonna be our data?
Yeah, I'm the recorder. I'm the secretary.
What you can do is make down any observations or notes that you see about the surroundings, if there's any signs of animal wildlife, if there's any points of pollution that you might see.
Okay, so what do I do next, instructor?
We put this in there.
Drained out. All right, take that clip off of that bag.
Dump it in there, right?
Yes, sir.
There's two clips. This one's double.
Now, could I just like, since this is a cipher or whatever, could I just like stick it down in the water and like kind of?
Yeah.
Do it like that.
I'd say that we could because I think that everyone else has already gotten theirs out and they're starting to sift through them. So there's no reason why we shouldn't be able to because I don't think we would disturb any of their results down there.
There we go.
If I can just kind of try to do it like that.
Yep.
Some of these little rocks
be
for those
people.
What?
Could
some of these little rocks
be for those people? Yeah, sure. Yeah, I think that's a little fine. All right.
Because
once
of these, they're in the coverage.
We'll get that cleaned out. You can do it just in case we have time to do a Shannon index.
All right, what's next?
All right. If you have that all nice and cleaned out to the best of your ability, we will put it in there, and then y'all can start rushing
through. All of it in there?
Yeah. Or if you want to do just a little bit at a time, because
nothing will
get out of
there.
It's whatever you want to do.
It'll make, we can just do, we do it all. Yeah.
That'll work.
Hey guys, while y'all are recording everything, make sure to look around and see what the habitat's like and see what can make this habitat ideal or not so ideal for the critters and stuff you find here.
Damn.
Doesn't that mean it's healthy?
Healthy streams.
Yeah. What else? Yeah, that's what I was looking at.
That's cool. Look at that.
So they just leave their shells behind?
Yeah, they do. They'll build that little tunnel and then just leave it. Like a hermit crab leaves their shell. Yeah. It's amazing.
You want the string? You want the sifter? It's pretty hard to catch it in the water, though.
I could buy that. This thing's going pretty quick for you. And they're not already gone. They're probably like tucked away hiding.
So really?
Be out.
Because of the rain.
Yeah. Yeah.
Makes sense.
The Hillsboro Zoo back over here towards group number one. I think everybody's going to congregate.
Is everybody kind of
ramping up? One.
What'd y'all find? Anything cool?
Three of those little maggot things.
Elephidopterus?
Yes, those.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Aquatic moth. Anybody find any salamanders or anything yet? Anything cool like that?
Yeah. Zach, did you find anything?
Stoneflies.
There's a bag from
Oh. Yeah, guys, let's make sure everybody has their bag, their mesh bags, if y'all don't mind. Y'all come this way. Alright guys, let's all just wrap up and kind of head up the hill here.
Chris, is that all you got?
I believe so. So I just kind of dump your species down in there in the water and we'll head back up to the van here.
Alright, we're not bringing the zoos.
Yeah. Alright. So just kind of dump everything out, put it back in the river and just kind of head up the hill if you don't mind.
Thanks for getting those bags. So what you got there? Oh, do you really? Oh, that's good. Oh, yeah, something opening up, raccoon or something. Absolutely. Absolutely. And that was your cell phone and the leaves. Okay, just so I saw it. I want to make sure you didn't forget it. Okay. All right. idea.
You got a stone fly, a big fat fly.
Nice.
Is that what it all shows?
Caddis flies have that. I always think caddis casing. Caddis kind of have the casing there, yeah. Caddis flies have that casing.
So
some of them are beautiful.
It's getting hotter, and they just leave there.
I think they, honestly, they leave it because they get too big for it, and they get it. They get another one. Yeah, I think is what they're doing. Yep. Yes, sir. I'm going to go ahead. Tell you what, Chris, you have anything else to teach them, or
no,
we're going back?
We're going to
all right, so I'm going to pause it here.